Hello students, today I welcome you all to the lecture series Understanding Computer. We are now at the lecture number 4 and we will continue with the study binary number system, and we will further dive into binary number system, that why and how it is important, and also what actually is binary number system. So last day I have talked about greed, so today we will talk about axioms. So the computer scientists or the mathematicians or the inventors of computer has a vision to make some device which can perform mathematical calculations. But you have a vision or you have a dream, that doesn't mean anything until and unless you take action. So there is a famous saying, dreaming is nothing without actions. So you have a dream, you have a vision, we have something called goal or target. You have to take actions to reach at that point, to reach the destination, right? So similarly, the computer scientist taken the actions, and now we see computers all around us. The world, every job of this world is now somehow associated with a computer operation. So I hope you understand the meaning of taking actions. But now the problem is, how or what should be the effect of our actions? Like, if you take actions, we may fail, right? Computer scientists, the inventors, where they are failing because they didn't have the system, binary number system. They didn't thought of taking this into consideration to compute or to make device. So before that, they were facing many problems. Like, you have known Abacus, right? The balls and the stick, right? To calculate numbers, right? They were taking that, but they faced many problems until and unless they come up with the system, binary number system. And when they come up and when they thought, yes, we will take binary number system in and incorporate with our thoughts of making computers, then computer is now vast because of the binary number system. Because using binary number system, we can explore, or we can basically represent any type of data around us. So they have taken the actions, and also you should also take actions towards your dreams. But before taking actions, you should have a dream. So moving on, we are on the lecture number 4. And now we are at the second part of binary number system. So we will understand how to convert binary to decimal. But before going into that, we should also first learn the reverse, that is decimal to binary. So let's take an example of how to calculate decimal binary number of a decimal number, or binary equivalent of a decimal number. So this is the way we represent, right? We write here, let's say 15, and we give the base as 10, and we ask what is the decimal value. So 2 is representing the binary number system and 10 is representing the decimal number system. So we have asked you the question that, given the decimal number 15, find its binary equivalent. So now we learn how to find it. First, we will use the division method. and we will find the result. So here is the number 15. We will divide it by 2. So when we will divide it by 2, the result will be 7.5. So we will take the integer part, which is 7, and when we multiply, the 7 into 2 will be 14. So there is the remainder 1. So we write the remainder here. Again, we will divide 7 by 2. So this will give 3 as the quotient and 1 as the remainder. Again, we will divide it by 2. Then it will give the quotient 1 and remainder 1. So now we will write this binary number system in this reverse manner. So first we will start from here, then here this number, then this number, then this number. So binary equivalent will be first this one, second this one, third this one, and fourth this one. So the binary number of binary equivalent of 15 will be 1111. Now let's take another example to help you understand. Let's take another number, let's say 56. So 56, the number is 56, we will again write and we will divide it by 2. So question will be 28. And the remainder will be 0. Again, we will divide it by 2. So the quotient will be 14 and remainder will be 0. Again, we divide it by 2. So quotient will be 7, remainder will be 0. Now, again, we divide it by 2. So we now finish at 1. We will finish either at 1 or 0. Now we will write the number in this direction. So first we will start with this one, then this one, then this one, and continue up to the first remainder. So this will be 3, 1 and 3, 0. This we will start number 1 from here. We will go up to this first remainder. First remainder. This is first remainder, and this one is the last quotient. So from the last quotient, we will make second last the last remainder, and we will go up to first remainder. And we will write in this fashion, and so the number, this number is representing 56 in decimal value, and the binary equivalent of 56 will be this number. So let's take another one example to clarify our. It's quite simple to understand. Let's take another number as, let's say 42. So it will be 21. So now we reached at the end. So we first divide 42 by 2. It will be the 21 and the remainder will be 0.
Now we again divide by 10 2, the quotient will be 10 and remainder will be 1. Again we divide it by 2, then quotient will be 5, the remainder will be 0. We divide it by 2, quotient will be 2 and remainder will be 1. We divide it by 2, the remainder will be 0 and the quotient will be 1. Now we again start from here and we will reach here and we will read this corresponding numbers and then this number will be the binary equivalent of number 42. So the binary equivalent of the number 42 will be 101010. So this will be the NSB and this is LSB. This is least significant bit and this is most significant bit. So what is a bit? Right. Every digit is a bit. So in decimal number system we say this is a digit. So if we write 42, then 2 is a digit, 4 is a digit. So in binary number system we say this one has bit. So every bit, every number that is 1 or 0 is a bit in binary number system. And this one will be the LSB. So least significant bits, but it will come at the right end, and most significant bit it will come at the left end. Now this is the whole conversion thing about how to convert a decimal number into binary number. Now we will learn the reverse process, that is how to convert binary number into decimal number. Let's take an example. Let's say we write here 110001. This two. What is its decimal equivalent? So you remember that if we have written 49, then what we say that is this is 9. Into 0, sorry, 9 into 1, I'm sorry, 9 into 1, and this is 4 into 10. And if we have, let's say, 245, then this is 9 into 1, 4 into 10, so this is decimal number system, and we have whatever the corresponding digit is, we multiply with 10 to the power the number of the digit. So it is at 0th position, it is at 1 position. So we, if we write it as 0, 1, 0, 1, 2. So it is at, so 9 is written as 9 into 10 to the power 0 plus 4 is written as 4 into 10 to the power 1. So if we sum this number, that is 4 into 10 to the power 1 plus 9 into 10 to the power 0, then we will get 49, right? So again, for this number, we say if we write 2 into 10 to the power 2 plus 4 into 10 to the power 1 plus 5 into 10 to the power 1. Right. So it will be 200, it will be 40,
will be fine. So the sum is 245. Okay. So similarly, we can do it in binary number system. But remember, in decimal number system, we have 10 digits. So we need multiply it by 10. The factor will be 10 to the power n or to the power I, whatever this is. Let's say this is the n value, the position value. So 10 to the power the position value. So we have decimal number system. Oh, sorry, we have binary number system. Then 10 will be 2, because in binary number system there are only 2 numbers. So the value will be here 1 into 2 to the power 1. Let's first index our number. So let's say we write it again here. 1 1 0. Let's index our number first. So it is at 0 position, 1, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th. So we have total 6 bits here. And now what we will do is 1 into 2 to the power 0, 0 into 2 to the power 1, 0 into 2 to the power 2, 0 into 2 to the power 3, 1 into 2 to the power 4, 1 into 2 to the power 5. So, what will be the value of this one? Let's start with from here. So, 2 to the power 0 will be 1, 1 into 1 will be 1. Yeah. 0 into something, so 2 to the power 1 will be 2, and into 0 will be 0. So, 0. Again, we will have 2 square, which is 4, and we will have 0. 0. Now, 2 to the power 4 will be 16. 16 into 1, 16. So, add. Now, add. 32. So, we have 32 to the power 5, 32. So, 32 plus 16, which will be 48, plus 1, 49. So, the number will be 49. Now, if we divide 49 so let me erase this. So we divide 49 by 2. So it will be 24, so 1, 2, it will be 12, 0, 2, 0, 6, 2, 0, 3, 2, 1, 1. So we write it 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So this both numbers are same. 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. One one zero 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 one and 110001. So the number coming will be 49. So again in this question, let's take another example to clarify. That's another example. B 101100001. So this number will be 1 into 2 to the power 0, 0 into 2 to the power 2, 0 into 2 to the power 3. Sorry. 0 into 2 to the power 3, 1 into 2 to the power 4, 1 into 2 to the power 5, 0 into 2 to the power 6. So we have total 8 units. Now what we will do is we will add all these numbers. So we will find the result. So it is 2 to the power 7 will be 128 plus 0 plus 32 plus 16 plus 0 plus 0. So when we add this number, 128 plus 32 will be 160, and then 176, and then 177. So the number will be 177. Now you can reverse the process for this 177, and you can cross-check your answer. So I have a homework for you. Based on whatever you have learned today, try to write binary number for let's say 10 to 50. For numbers 10 to 50, try to write binary number, and you can find it is easy, right? 10 to 50 is not so much work, just try to find it. Before that, I will show you how to write binary numbers for 0 to 10. Okay. So for 0, we have no number, it will be 0, for 1, 1. Because these two numbers fall in the binary number system itself. Now for 2, so 2, we will divide it by 2, so there will be 0 remainder and 1 present. So 1, 2. Now 3, if we have 3 here, so the quotient will be 1 and remainder will be 1. So first one and 1. Now for 4, we divide it by 2, we again divide it by 2, and we will finally 1. So the number will be 100. So similarly, if you calculate, you will have to add 1, so 101, then 110, then 111. Then 1000. Then for 9, in this way you have from 0 to 10 all the binary numbers. So today we have learned the conversion of decimal number into binary number and the conversion of binary number into decimal number, and based on that I have given you to try to write binary numbers from 10
to 50. Okay. If you find something interesting, here is the clue. If you find such kind of pattern, that is, we have only one month in this in these numbers. So find it and please try it at home so that you can practice. And after that, from after this lecture, whenever we need to convert binary numbers into decimal numbers or decimal to binary, we will be doing it fast too. So please practice it at home. And also revise previous lectures, because from next lecture, what we will learning is, let me tell you the topic. The first thing, so the next part we will learn is about data. That is, in the first topic we have talked about what is a text, what is an image, what is audio, what is video, and all that. So we will learn what actually are those things to computer, and how audio, video, images, text, and everything is represented into computer as a binary numbers. And we will also learn the ASCII code. Today we have taken it lightly, because you get enough time to practice our binary number system, so that when you use it, you don't have any problem in learning all that. So we will talk about text, images, videos, audios. We will talk about ASCII, and ASCII code. ASCII is basically codes for all the characters. Someone has asked how all the characters and how numbers are represented using binary numbers. So that we will call in this ASCII characters. Okay. So hope you all are having good time, and you all are safe at home. So continue learning. Thank you so much.